Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you so much for coming in tonight today, on a Saturday for New Breakthrough Solutions at the AI Conference. This is a platform for all of you to learn exactly what is Agile, what is Scrum, where can it be used, how will it be used. Right? So this is exactly for that purpose, and we need to ensure that we learn the maximum from our mentors and leverage from their strength and their knowledge, right? So we'll begin with the show today.
Company, if you want to really change, what we do is we change the culture. Every company has got a culture. So we are supposed to change the culture. Changing the culture. That's the only issue.
And many people, you are aware, shouldn't possess and change mindset and culture. So this mindset and culture, where, what is that, if you go to the next step, what is that mindset and culture we are talking about? Is the same manifesto, the four values, the manifesto and the principles, the principles. It is actually a different culture. For example, like, one of the challenges that you have is respect to your elders. So, how do you practice greeting them, wishing them, if it is a one-on-one response around them? So, those are the practices. So, agile is again, as you said, it's an umbrella word. And you have different practices. And so, when you have multiple practices, we bring in one problem.
I think also like focus on agile principles. So, there are told 12 principles total. Where the focus is on the team rather than product. So if you go through that those principles, there are 12 principles, and out of that, 8 are focused on team, whereas 3 are focused on product. Actually, 1 is common. So 7, so 1 is common, which is focused on team as well as on product. So Ajay is also saying that, like he said, that if you are able to change the team, you can always build a winning product. So that is what the focus. So before that, we were always focusing on the product that, okay, we'll do this, and then we'll deliver the product. If you have a winning team, you will always deliver a winning product. That is what the
Very interesting conversation that you guys have. But first thing, are we trying to get the old thing that we had and cover it up in a new clothes and present it? And because you said the product manager. In a traditional world, we had a product manager who has now become a Scrum Master. So traditionally, are we really going that agile way in the mid-management level? Because what's happening is we're just trying to go ahead and cater to the requirement that is there without actually being agile. Because a lot of things which you are doing when you are agile is not happening today also in projects. What's rather happening is we're just doing a traditional work, just dividing into smaller meal pieces and you're delivering. There's a huge challenge for people in a certain ranks where they have traditionally worked with a certain model for a very long time. They're part of this industry for a very long time. And now they all of a sudden, because of the Scrum and everything coming in, a lot of dynamics has changed. And although people say that you shouldn't command a team, but because they have been traditionally trained to do that, they end up doing that.
You came a little late, so Sahith was just talking about the same effects in the industry where people are still not used to the change, right? And it takes time, and it is going to take a lot of time. So he was just talking about transformation, he was just talking about a journey, right? So he says that 7 years experience is, they've been implementing Scrum. Still, it looks.
Not Scrum. Sorry. Yeah. So, see, that is where I tend to go with Joshua and Mark. So, initially, teams are by no summary information, even the managers, they act like, okay, I know Scrum. When they say some class, I know Scrum. But it's like half baked knowledge.
Every time, after every iteration, we are delivering something to them. They can see that, okay, this is how they want. If they want to change something, they can change immediately. So that is where they found, okay, this is the strength of Agile. And because of that, they were able to reduce their overall cost, which they were anticipated in the initial of the year. So that is the advantage they saw when they implemented Agile.
Probably delay the work. Can that be a reason for a delay in a project? Like, if you feel that it's a DNM, you may want to kind of extend the project a little more.
No, as you said, he was given higher value requirements. The reason is, in waterfalls, yes.
Benefit that they're able to show to
you. Yes. So, now there is something that introduced to me 80%. Okay. 80% of your satisfaction in delivery is derived from 20% of the usage.
Oh, yeah.
For example, you guys are using Facebook. No one who is not using this.
Me.
So, okay. let's take Mirani. I'm not a politician, so I'm going to. So, what do you do with Facebook?
Especially like you would like to post or you would like to
post, check in,
and all the friends of
the ladies who would like to post their new dresses and all this. Basically, you will use the feeds and the postings, but there are a lot of other things like
you can post your ad, you can become an advertiser, you can program against the API, you can create groups, you can create pages and all those things, but we are not using that. But we are delivering 80% of the satisfaction by just using those 20% of the feature, by uploading our profile picture, changing our profile picture and all those things. So those are the things which are valuable as a customer, and that's what we said. Now with Agile or any Agile methodology, that's what we are trying to do. And that's why procrastination doesn't happen, because the customer is always involved. He knows that okay, what are two teams? One team was high performing team, the other was not so much. Now what happened is the high performing team was getting all valuable news. The low performing team was getting all the stories which are of low value. So they want to get, already they were built, but they want to get the output of it. So the high performing team was getting all the good work, the low performing team was getting the. So this can also be seen.
See, when you're working as a team, it's like, for example, in a team you might have people with different experiences, industries, has created those layers. So why those layers are created, you have to go back again when there is a resource implementation form, right? When we are formed, we'll get in there, and when the Infosys form, seven people started the company. And when they started to grow, they want to have layers. And those layers are given as a carrot for the plumbers to to say that we are going, we are going. But unfortunately, a manager is not a techie anymore. Once he became a manager, he's not a techie anymore. If you see the industry, why the middle-level clients in how many years? They were techies. They were super techies till 4 years of experience. 2 years they become technical. That means they have to review other books. Like 8 years they become manager. That means they have to look into the budgeting, risk management. What? 8 years they have not done that. All of a sudden they are doing something called risk management. All of a sudden they are doing something called people management. Right? And they are not touching the code. And if, like if 3-4 years back when there was no middle of crisis, you go and ask your manager and say that I have a bug here, can you sit there and help me? You'll be like, no way.
But still, if any new joiner is coming to my team, I cannot say, okay, I am working as a senior tech lead. I am working as an agilist there. Okay, so in my team, I have to do testing, I have to give release to production, I have to do development as well. Okay, so all are related. It is not like, okay, this is only your responsibility and this is not your responsibility. And what we are doing, even my junior developer can also give release to production. That is what the confidence we have. And he is also reviewing my code, whatever I have written. So that is the thing which we have done in my team.
Yeah, it's not regarding responsibility what individual person is doing. For example, okay, example, you have a team of 6 people, so the funding is given to that particular team.
Right.
So in that team, see, if you set a percentage to individual, for example, 6% whatever it is to that particular team, individual person gets 6%. So a person who is getting more than 10 lakhs, 20 lakhs, for him, 6% is a big figure. But a person who's getting less pay, like below 10 or below 5, for him, 6 is too less. How do you go with that?
Our long-term vision is to change the whole designation thing also, which he is not aware. But what we are coming up as coaches is that down the line, we are going to include HR also. Right? We are saying that enough is enough. Now we are going to change everything, even the appraisal, even the designation, everything is going to change. And it is going to align with the agile principles. Okay, we want that tag of team leader manager. Because obviously we want our moms and dads to feel proud of it and mera beta manager.
No, that is fine.
For me personally, if a guy is 5 years experience, he would have learned 25% of the field. For example, I'm .NET has got a huge library. Even after 14 years in the industry, I still learn something new every other day.
You as a user get the right returns of whatever time your first was spending. So definitely it is not 6% to the team and the different pays. It is not a simple calculation like that. I don't realize that position and salary. Like I am an agile coach, myself is an agile coach, it all is same. It depends on our background, how many organizations we have changed.
That's
the
key factor.
But if a person has stayed in one organization has 10 years experience and if the other person has 10 years, he has stayed 5, that doesn't mean he is stronger.
No, we are not saying.
No,
I'm saying there is no direct equation that, okay, like a position and a rate, like your salary, is not same. It is how you have grown up in your career. That is one. And second, the organization. Like in some organization, like they pay heavily, like in some capping organization, and then in service organization, they pay slightly more. That's compared to that. So you and your friend, you are two different organizations. So that is where like the difference
is.
Based on my experience.
Performance is only one of the criteria for the project. It is not only the criteria.
Yeah.
It is one of the criteria.
Yeah.
You are right. One of the things which we implemented with Rocket like Startups software with my previous line is that where the team does a 360-degree evaluation of each and every one. Okay. For example, there are a team of 10 people. And they have 10 parameters on which they rate a person. And then there is a chief scrum master who takes this input and goes to the client and asks the client, okay, what do you think about these individuals? So when you talk about Scrum, you should interact with your end user, okay? And that is one of the criteria. So if you have 10 people, the client should know those 10 people. That is one of the expectations set. It's not that today Divya is the Scrum master, you should always interact, no. So that is the second level. And the third level is based on the company's profit also. That's what we implemented, which worked very well. The same may not work with some other company because you have to think about the culture of the company. Right? For example, I can talk in terms of software. It's a huge legacy. So we may not be including the same kind of thing where your chief scrum master is taking this to the customer and things like that. It will be totally different. But our way of implementation of the appraisal would be in this 360 plus some other criteria as well. The traditional appraisal system, the biggest problem was, if you are very close to the manager, you can rest assured you will get.
Just to understand, so all these inconsistencies now.
The basic differentiation is that agile coach is coming from outside, teaching the team, and then again, he will work for only some time, okay? Whereas Scrum Master is part of the team. So,
there are some companies are hiring full time agile coach and Scrum Master for one call.
So they have summed it wrongly.
Yes.
So just simply say Scrum Master, which should be good enough for them to.
So actually, what are you doing?
So the Scrum Master is not required at all.
Yeah.
So the Scrum Master is something different and the lean is something different. The Scrum Master, being a Scrum Master, I will handle the team and I will guide the team how to be in agile principles. This is Scrum Master. And agile coach is something like an organization level, the people are working at the XP program also, the people are working on Lean also, the people are also working on agile Scrum Master. So all this to be monitored by agile coach, I think, in this.
See, there are many different aspects as well. Okay. Now, I have seen a company where they started a pilot project to see how valuable it is. In that case, the company has recruited Scrum Master as well as Agile Coach. The reason is Scrum Master is fine. Now the Agile Coach will take that learning and disperse across the organization to streamline the process. And that could be also a reason. Okay. So the companies can recruit different people for different reasons. We never know what is the reason. And as you rightly said, but personally, if you ask me, Scrum Master, if he is a Scrum Master of a team which is performing Scrum, he has to follow Scrum, but it is not preventing him from doing campaign to another team.
Yes.
Now, if you talk about your Scrum, Jeff Sutherland and Ken's father, they say a team should have a Scrum Master from outside the team. Okay, he should not be part of the team. That is their recommendation. In that case, yes, a Scrum Master will be handling two or three teams.
Yeah.
And an agile coach can, see, the role of an agile coach is totally different. So, for example, I am being asked to coach a team. Okay. Now, I go and see what the team is working on. What is the volatility of their environment? For example, one of the teams is working on a ticketing system, okay, where they are doing maintenance. So in ticketing system, you cannot wait for a 2 week sprint or 1 week sprint. You have to give a response immediately. So for that, you will go and implement Kanban. Okay, so as you rightly said, agile coach role is totally different. It is to go and give train and implement certain solutions based on the Scrum. Whereas the Scrum Master is purely dedicated to Scrum, but it is not preventing him or her from learning something.
Sorry, one more answer. Correct me if I'm wrong. Like he asked me the meaning of the project. Agile, I believe, like we don't I'm billing the minimum cost for the entire project. We will cost it for the MVP only, the minimum viable product we charge is. For example, we have 1,000 requirements, like we have an objective of, as an investor, I want to have an e-commerce website, same as Flipkart. When I approach a company, company says that we will not build for the, we will not cost it for the 3 years of building what we want to do for the next 3 years. We will cost it for the 1 year what we want to show you for you. That is for MVP. They will charge for that.
Not even 1 year, they will not even charge for 1 year.
They will charge for 1 year.
They will say, okay, I will give you only for those sprints of the year. They will completely accurately stop the sprint also. When for them, if they see the value in that product, they will stop for it is not restricting you from doing it. As you said, one company may have an MVP approach. Another client may say, no, I don't want MVP approach. I would just fund you for every sprint where you are delivering value. But there are different approaches. Now, as Anthony said, one of the biggest problems what we are facing is because of the services company. Okay, they cannot do a outcome based. The reason is the person who is going to sell the product or who is going to get business, his salary is pretty low, but his commission is very high. So what fixed budget, if he gets 100 crore fee, he will get 10 crore. But if it is outcome based, he may not get that 10 crore immediately.
To answer your question, the moment you enter a company which believes in agile, you will not see walls, you will not see cubicles, nothing. Okay? You will see an open environment and you will see each and everyone believe in the problem. They will not leave you waiting in their waiting area for long. And they will be disciplined enough. The moment you come, you will be engaged in different things. Don't worry, that itself will give you that vibe that okay, this company is agile and it values people. Simple as that. You will have that vibe. Okay. Now talking about yours. Okay. Now when you are agile team and when you are non-agile team, the best approach is first start educating them, saying that every 2 weeks or every 4 weeks we are going to deliver something and we want interaction with people. Okay. You follow whatever you want. We are least one, but we want this least commitment from you that you are going to interact with us on a regular basis. So start building that cadence with them. Okay. So that is the first thing you have to do, is start having dialogue with them because they may not understand the way you work. So we are also in the same situation where Bangalore team is in Agile and Thais team is not. So what we do is that we get a commitment and we say that okay, see, this is what we are doing and we want bare minimum commitment of so and so, so and so, so and so. And it is not a big commitment. Okay, it will be maybe 4 hours of meeting in 2 weeks, that would be the bare commitment. So work out that commitment with them and tell them and start educating them. So I will put the responsibility on the Scrum Master saying that, okay, as a Scrum Master, you need to take this and the team should not think about all these things and break their head. And the Scrum Master should start getting involved with them and start talking. See, one of the easiest things is if you can travel to that person and meet face to face, maybe for me, a lot of things can get done. Yes. So if that is the case, that is the best thing to go talk face to face and sort things out. Okay. Close your eyes.
Velocity as a measurement.
Okay. Now velocity can be measured as you rightly said. Yes. Now I forgot the guy's name. Mustafa. Yeah. So you can achieve performance from a certain object up to a certain level. So velocity is not something which you want to keep increasing. We want a stabilized velocity. So if you go by one of the principles, it says the team should work towards getting something which is stabilized. So that is the key. You need to target for a stabilized velocity. And when we coach people, we are not coaching teams. We are coaching managers and people who are managing teams, people managers and everyone. We tell them that, okay, see, you cannot expect people, a team to perform always at a higher throughput. Classic example is processes. Okay, it was predicted that we can extract so much only from process. Now if you see processes are maximum 2.7 gigahertz, but what we are doing, we are doing parallel processing. We have Ankaa code, we have Yol code, blah, blah, blah. So that's the same thing applies with people also. As you said, we would put more people. That would not increase the velocity at all. That would actually kill your velocity. The reason is, you have to educate that person, you have to mentor that person, you have to train that person. So that kind of a coaching has to happen. And the one of the reasons what I feel why these kind of things are happening is there are no coaches in any company. Okay?
coach has to be there. So when I have seen, when I go and coach, and when a team member says, it's a totally different ball game. Okay, as a coach, yes, if you have the luxury, start approaching a coach and tell them, boss, come and help us. This is what our situation is. If you go and start coaching the other person, if he's a superior, he's a good partner, but he's a kind of, you can't listen.
Yeah.
So it's always good to get an external influence. So that
is
why
I have the last responses.
Yeah,
maybe
yeah.
Just next few minutes that we have to do.
So just to add, there's a last one, we're not taking much countries as the last we are talking about. So one of the principles is working software with the government. So unfortunately, velocity also being measured. So, but if you still want metrics, I can give you two metrics, which really makes sense. One is customer NPS. NPS is net promoter score.
Okay.
And the other one is team NPS. These
right.
Are the team NPS. Team. So, when I say customer NPS, ask your PMOs and stakeholders, are they happy with the way in which the software is being delivered? So, that is our primary metrics. Second one is ask your team NPS. In your retrospective, you can come back, ask them their morale. There is also a lot of software out there, morale.com. But if you can also try to gauge their emotional engagement with the team, the company, if you are able to measure these two, then that gives you the two metrics.
Yeah.
So to add to on the networks and also we have to do a very good incident that happened in front of me on the client side. We were like sitting like this for a sprint review, and sprint review was done. There were three agile teams and 100 story points delivered. The project manager said, team, thank you very much, you have done a wonderful job, 100 story points delivered, let's try to achieve more velocity. Okay. The VP of that organization was there in the same. He openly said, sorry team, I want to correct this work here. Okay, velocity is none of your business. We just focus on doing your best. Velocity is, looking at velocities is my problem, is Mr. PM's problem, is Mr. Scrum Master's problem. So we all three will see what are the things that are impacting your velocity. We'll keep on cleaning, you just keep on working on your stuff.
So in this case, we'll be a proof coach.
Yeah, so that is where like our executive buy-in is so important in any agile institution. So velocity is not so good the metrics. Judge something. But to add to, if I have to see two metrics, one is the number of releases you are doing. That is what your time to market. Today you are doing one year release and you are now incrementally building the working software, right? So now that releases again, some people can say, okay, I have only 1 year release. Okay, if you are still incrementally releasing to your pre-prod environment, that is still create a common understanding about Agile. And then train and transform, not only train the like whatever stakeholders you are talking about, the different three groups or four groups and yeah, different things. So train and transform, just not focus only training. Because most of the transformation what they do is they just focus on training. Okay, I have trained 100 people and then they know understand what is Scrum, what to how to do daily Scrum, and then you just go.
You should train the coach.
Yeah. So don't focus on training, focus on transformation. That is it. So
great. So I'm so sorry. I know that you know we have so many things, and I personally had so many questions to ask. But you know, fortunately or unfortunately, we have some limited time, you know, which we have kind of get this completed. So I hope you know the session has been of some learning for all of you. And I hope and I wish that I can probably have these kind of sessions as often as I can, at least once in a month, right? And we may just kind of change the context, we may probably change the format, we may try to kind of add some more ingredients, team level activities or games, which can be probably played, you know, probably from next month onwards, which will, you know, create some more energy or bring in more energy into the class, right? And, but having said that, I really want to thank all of you. All the participants and everybody who's, you know, probably, you know, I'm sure this is one of your priority, right? Growth, career, learning, you know, probably meeting people, understanding from them in terms of what they've done in their career. So that is definitely one of your top priorities, and that's why you're here, right? And I really want to thank all of you for, you know, probably thinking about contributing and being participative, right, and giving a lot of insight of your and about your experience, sharing a lot of your experience. So I thank all of you, right, and hope you all enjoyed the session. Right, and hope to meet all of you as soon as possible. Yeah.
Sure.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Thanks a lot.
Thanks a lot.